Dear Greg, my husband Bill drives like a maniac. He's always over the speed limit, sometimes 20 miles an hour over, or more. He weaves in and out of traffic like he was driving in the Grand Prix, and he rides on people's bumpers so close that it scares me to death. I've talked to him about this more times than I can count, but every time I do, he just gets angry. This makes me so mad. It's not fair that he can drive like he wants, and I'm trapped in the passenger seat, scared to death. What can I do? This is tearing up our marriage.
More understanding is usually helpful. So we'll try to gain a little of that, and then we'll talk about some choices you can make. First, let's look to understand why your husband has this need to drive fast. When people don't have enough of the one thing they need most in order to be happy, real love, they reach out to fill their emptiness with whatever form of imitation love they can find. They use money, sex, power, conditional approval, and so on. When your husband drives fast, he's using pleasure in the form of excitement. He gets an adrenaline rush that temporarily distracts him from the emptiness in his life. As he passes other cars, as he flaunts the driving laws, and as he just controls the speed and direction of the car, he also gets a feeling of power. I describe what Bill gets from driving fast so that you can understand that his behavior has nothing to do with you. Yes, I know that it affects you, and it's true that he's being quite inconsiderate of your feelings, but he doesn't drive crazily primarily to intentionally irritate you. He does it because it's one of the few ways he has in his life to feel the pleasure and power that distract him from the emptiness in his life. This doesn't excuse his behavior, but the better you understand his behavior, the more you'll be able to feel compassion toward him rather than irritation. It will also help you to understand the feelings you are having when he drives fast. It's obvious that you feel a physical fear that he's going to drive you headlong into a bridge abutment or oncoming traffic and kill you, but even when he's not actually endangering your life, there's something else about his driving that bothers you even more than the physical threat. Every time he drives in a way that disregards your need for safety, you hear him saying with his behavior, "I don't care about you. I don't love you." And you're right. That is what he's saying. He's saying that if the excitement he gets from driving like a crazy man involves a high cost for you, if it makes you afraid, makes you feel unloved, then tough. He really doesn't care if his behavior affects you in a negative way. And that message, that he doesn't care about you, hurts you especially badly because you already don't feel loved. You're already in pain as a result of a lifetime of not having enough real love. So in that condition, it doesn't take much for him to push you over the edge. That creates a real problem, which we'll talk about in our next session.